So our next match is men's singles again, and we will find out who Victor Axelsen will be playing in tomorrow's quarterfinal. Will it be the number two seed, the 10-time former champion Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia, or Son Wan Ho of Korea? Well, as the players wait in the wings, I can tell you that Steen Pedersen was absolutely right. 2007 quarterfinal, Lee Chong Wei, last time that he lost in this event. Well, I can tell you that Lin Dan is safely through to play against Jan Jorgensen. He won his match against Boonsak Ponsana, 21-15, 21-9. So in this bottom half of the draw, just one quarterfinal place to be decided. And it's the match we're about to watch.
On court one, men's singles, Son Wan Ho.
So the Korean Son Wan Ho announced to come forward onto court. Never beyond this stage of this tournament. But just listen to the roar for the home player, Lee Chong Wei. The number two seed. 10 times he's won this title. The first in 2004. What an incredible record he has here on home soil. Chris Yip of Hong Kong, our umpire for this one. And yes, it was 9 years ago the last time this man lost here. Quarterfinal stage of 2007 when he was the number two seed, lost out to Bao Chun Lai, who then lost in the final to Peter Gaeder, as we were saying a little earlier. But his opponent first, Son Wan Ho, is 27 years of age, although he'll turn 28 next month. He is up two places in the world ranking this week, as you can see, to number 11. Has been as high as number four, 11 weeks as number four. Two separate spells at that career high of four. Now he, in the first round, had to play against the qualifier, Go Soon Huat of Malaysia. 21-13 in 52 minutes in that deciding game. So to Lee Chong Wei, the 33-year-old from Georgetown, Penang. Of course, he has been world number one. Down one place in the world ranking, on the world ranking published earlier today. So down to number four, 10 titles. 11 finals here. This is 15th appearance. And he beat in the first round a man who was promoted from the qualifying, Takuma Ueda of Japan. Just 33 minutes to dispose of him. So this will be the 10th meeting between the two players. And of the previous nine, Lee Chong Wei has not only won eight, but he's won the last four. The last time they met was in Dongguan in the Suriman Cup quarterfinal. Quarterfinal, which of course Korea ended up winning 3-1. But the one match that Malaysia did win in that Suriman Cup was Lee Chong Wei's, as you saw, 21-17, 21-12. So Chris Yip and Christian Johannesson. They did our first match, didn't they? But the opposite way around. No, the service judge is now the umpire, and the umpire is now the service judge.
Ready? Ladies and gentlemen, on our right, Lee Chong Wei.
Level. So Lee Chong Wei getting this second. Oh my goodness, that's absolutely plumb on the line. What a way to start this second round match. Well, take that. He's sent a message of intent.
Almost like a show match.
Hey, yeah.
I'll do the short service, you'll lift to my forehand, or I'll hit it on the line.
And it's gone long. Well, of course, Lee Chong Wei, the end of last year, three titles back to back. Three Super Series titles, I should say. French Super Series, Hong Kong Super Series, China Super Series. Of course, China was before Hong Kong. And then at the beginning of this year, his first tournament of the year, the Malaysian Grand Prix Gold. He promptly won that. So four consecutive tournament titles in four tournaments played. But Steen, since then, been a little bit of a hiccup for Lee Chong Wei. Of course, at the All England Championships, he was the number two seed, lost in the first round to Sai Praneeth of India last week. This is a good rally, isn't it? Oh, that's landed in. That's come back in. Last week, he was the number one seed in India, and he lost in the second round to Wei Nan. But I was reading comments from his coach, Hendra Wan, that no need to panic. He's been doing some really good training in preparation, and everything, of course, for him is geared towards Rio Olympic Games.
Yeah. Very good remarks from Hendra Wan, and very appropriate. And the interesting thing to see is what about the Malaysian media? Can they sort of accept this? I think a lot comes down to this tournament here in Shah Alam on home soil. He's won it so many times, so I think people expect him to go far in this tournament, and I think he almost has to win it. But he's got a tough way.
Yeah. But you see, that was another thing that Hendra once said, because he said the Malaysian public mustn't expect him to win the whole time.
Exactly, exactly. I couldn't agree more. I mean, you have to give your players time to do the tough training. It's just so important that you can't play and play and play and expect to play well in all tournaments. It's not so often that you see that described in the media. It will be interesting to see an article on how the periodization is done throughout a year. We have these 2 months, January and February, where there's no Super Series tournaments. Of course, Chong Wei had to play the Malaysian Grand Prix Gold. So he's perhaps prolonged this period a little bit.
Sun Wan Ho last year was the number three seed. He lost in the first round to Xue Song. I don't know, Steen, if you've heard any news about Xue Song. I mean, it was a horrendous injury. You wouldn't have seen it last week because it wasn't on the television court. I saw wincing
afterwards.
Yeah. I wince because I've had five knee operations, and it looked to me as if it was a very, very nasty knee injury.
I saw somewhere that they mentioned that it was a torn meniscus.
Oh, well, that's not as bad as ligaments, I guess.
But then it's about what happens when you look inside that knee. Is everything intact there, or are there other injuries as well? Terrible blow for Xue Song, who was, in my opinion, on the way to at least reaching the final and perhaps winning it, because he played Victor Axelsen, I think, in the All England and beat him. So, in my opinion, he would have been the favorite.
Look how Lee Chong Wei is taking the shuttle early. Look at that.
out?
No,
it's come back in.
I thought it would go at least to the middle of the small doubles field. Stayed in. That's one of the longest rallies of today, isn't it, Jill? 28 shots.
Yeah, I think it is.
It's been very inconsistent, Sun Wan Ho, in my opinion. Last week beat Lin Dan, and then lost easily to Victor Axis.
Yeah.
It's been going up and down with his results. I can't really figure him out.
No. Of course, he's won two Super Series titles as Sun Wan Ho. India 2012, when he beat his opponent of today. That was his only victory over Lee Chong Wei. In the 2014 Hong Kong, when he beat Chen Long in the final.
And that's where I thought he was going to make his final breakthrough to the top five and sort of stamp his mark there, but he hasn't been able to keep it up, and then suddenly he pops up and makes some really, really good results. And of course, we also know that the Korean players, they're doing some military services at strange times, and there's no exception unless you have an Olympic medal. So that might be some of the explanation.
I think there are some other exceptions as well. Asian Games.
Probably.
Gold
probably,
medal.
Yeah. The big,
I think maybe world titles as well. I'm not sure. I did get told this once from my friend Don Hearn, and who lives in Korea, and I can't remember.
At least these two big multi-sports events get you exempt from military service.
Yeah.
And of course, as I'm told, also some kind of pension.
Mm.
So there's a lot at stake there.
Yeah. Well, I know after the 2012 Olympics, Sun Wan Ho was out for 9 months, did his military duty, and then had shin splints, and so was away from the game for 9 whole months, which is quite a time.
It's actually amazing to be able to come back.
Mm. No, he's overdone it. He's hitting with the sideways drift going that way. Well taken.
And he's been playing well so far, Sun Wan Ho here, employing a more defensive style than I would have thought would be possible.
It's amazing the amount of badminton he's played of late, isn't it? Because he played the German Grand Prix gold, the All England, then he went down to New Zealand. He played last week in India. He's also entered, I notice, into the Singapore Super Series next week, then the China Masters, and then the Asian Championships.
And it's more or less hold the Korean team that plays so many tournaments.
So that's 8 tournaments in 9 weeks. Surely if they do well and get Olympic qualification points, they won't play all of those, will they? Maybe they will.
Sure. At least it's something that that some of the Europeans might think about. If the Koreans can play 8 weeks out of 9, why is it that we have to go back home after 2 weeks only?
Yeah. No. Ho Hoon Hwae, the Korean coach. And there's Hendrawan for Lee Chong Wei. 4 points adrift at the moment, and Tae Soo Bok.
Caught 1, 20 seconds.
So 11-7. Yeah, yes, that's nice.
Yeah, that's well played.
Follow up. Good attacking play. Great reactions, great reactions from Lee Chong Wei. Well, I don't know what Hendra Wan said, but whatever he said has worked.
Four straight points after the interval.
Yeah.
And he's been attacking the backhand side of Song Wan Ho relentlessly. I think that's important because that has been one of the issues with Chong Wei over the years when he was playing good opposition, that when he doesn't get through with his attack a couple of times, then he sort of backs off and never uses it. But now he's keeping on doing it,
yeah.
and just changing a little bit of the placement or the pace and so on, and suddenly he gets through.
Eases into the lead, 6 of the 7 points since the mid-game interval.
Say though, one or two smashes, or stick smashes to the body or to the forehand side might keep the backhand side even more open.
Afraid to lift there, thinking about the drift. Maybe he'd changed his mind, I don't know, but it looked a very funny final net shot, didn't it, from Song Wan Ho.
That's a good shot.
Oh, challenge here. Well, it's the opposite end from where we're sitting, so it's very difficult for us to tell. But the challenge was immediate. Well, I thought instinctively it may have landed in, but as I say, very, very difficult for us to tell. Hawkeye will tell us. Yeah, we were right. Line judge was right.
Unsuccessful. Service over. 14-0. Lee Chong Wei, one challenge remaining. Play.
Oh, he's missed it. That was a wide open court. Looks up towards the 15, lights.
40.
Yeah, they've done all the hard work. You know, I think the sideways drift is considerably different from end to end.
Yeah, it's possible.
Yeah. Which isn't really much help to people watching because I don't know which way it's going. Steen, you must have telepathy with him or something.
I don't think so.
Bearing it up more now, his attack. It's a very, very clever body smash.
Blanca, wipe the clock, please.
When there's this much of a drift and when it's unpredictable like we believe it is here in the stadium, what happens is that the players, they start playing with bigger margins towards the lines because it doesn't pay to play close to the lines because there will be too many mistakes. The only place it pays to play with sharp shots is at the net.
Yeah. That's gone long.
Service over. 16-0.
Oh, yes. Pounced on that, didn't Lee Chong Wei.
17-16.
It was like he read that from someone who the forehand shot.
Play, please.
The racket position and the body position.
Thank you.
Well, he's opened up a two-point cushion. Now, thankfully, the players weren't disturbed. We suddenly got a spotlight in our eye, didn't we?
Yeah, I was sitting here smiling. Must be someone photographing. Couldn't see any of the court, though, but doesn't matter.
Oh, that goes down as a unforced error from Lee Chong Wei. Phenomenally good. That smash was inch perfect. Just inside the line. That's what you were talking about. Giving yourself a little margin for error. Well, that wasn't much of a margin for error. Well, that's the longest rally of the match so far, isn't it? Challenge here, and I think he's right to challenge. We're not in the best position to see that line, but instinctively I thought that was just a fraction out. But Hawkeye will tell us for sure.
Very important.
Yeah, it's a
decision here. There it is.
Oh, it's caught the line.
Yeah.
It was in. Yeah. Well, I was wrong. Line judge was right.
20, game point 70. Song Wan Ho, one challenge remaining. Play.
So three game point opportunities for the 10-time former champion. Well saved, isn't it?
And 10 times, that's an awful lot of years you've played the tournament. 15 times, you said earlier.
Yeah.
And 10 times winning it, that's 10 times where everything has sort of fit together on the same occasion. That's really extraordinary.
Yeah, plus one final back in 2003. Lost out to Chen Hong. Opening game on his second game point opportunity, 21-18. No, that little spurt after the mid-game interval, that was very, very impressive. 6 of 7 points after the mid-game interval, and that was just what he needed. 21-18, opening game. Well, the coaches depart the court. Instructions from these two coaches.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Think you like that?
So Lee Chong Wei, having won that opening game, 21-18. Seven times finalist.
Second game.
15th appearance. His first appearance here.
Level.
As we start the second flat. Game. He came through the qualifying round in the year 2000. Lost in the last 64. It was a draw of 64 then. Perfect, isn't it? You don't get any better than that. Hit the top of the tape and just trickled over. Look at this. Perfection. Well, he stood his ground. I think he was expecting the drop shot rather than... Well, I'm not sure whether that was a backhand smash or backhand drive. More of a drive, I think.
Yeah. A drive that went too high.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a really, really important first game, I think, for Lee Chong Wei after his two tournaments in India and All England. It was nice to win the first game on a tough opponent like someone who... to take a few more chances when you have the first game in the back. Loosens up a little bit.
Yeah, and also for Sun Wan Ho, when you're playing against the Malaysian in Malaysia, where you know he's had so much success, then it's very difficult psychologically for Sun Wan Ho to think and believe that he can come back. So Lee Chong Wei is on a high and someone Ho's on a low.
Exactly. It's going to be a tough day at the office if he's going to come back. And I mean, if you're 17 all with Chong Wei in the first game, you want to capitalize from that and winning the game. And he wasn't able to do it. And now I think he's facing trouble here in the second game. Brilliant.
I was going to say to you, Steen, what, you know, is there something different that Sun Ho should be doing? But then I stopped myself because I thought he really, to me, and maybe I'm belittling him, but to me he seems to only really have one way of playing.
Yeah, I thought we would see him in a more attacking style here because he would need it. We really haven't seen him that much attacking. Perhaps it's been much for him because we haven't seen him play clear rallies or anything like that, but that's also due to Chong Wei that he's sort of firing away on everything that's yeah. above the tape. I feel that he has a little edge in his backhand side at the net if he wants to take control of the rallies. I feel he's got a little bit better touch in his backhand than Chong Wei's got in his forehand, but looks like it's not enough to sort of take control of the match.
Yeah. It's gone way, way long. Yeah. It was interesting. We had a little glimpse there of the Malaysian coaches, and I think Taiso Bok was looking across at a very interesting women's doubles. That's got to be a first. He's obviously feeling confident about his man. Absolutely brilliant. It was the shot before that did the damage,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Yeah, it was the deception.
that one.
Yeah, and if you're off balance, you have no chance of controlling your shot in the drift here. If it has the correct length, it's just luck.
Now, what was that you were saying towards the end of the first game about those steep smashes down the forehand side? I think
Lee
Chong Wei is doing it.
As a variation, it would be good. Interesting to see if he's targeting the forehand side here of Song Wan Ho, because then it might be something about the half of the court.
No, that's nice. Now that's perhaps what you'd like to see him do a little more of, someone home.
Yeah. It's also quite short, the lift from Chong Wei.
So he's got to choose his right one, not all out attack. He's got to build the rally first.
Yeah. That's going to be a really hard way for someone who winning from the defense. I don't think it's possible. Not after losing the first game here.
In Open titles, Lee Chong Wei, 41 Super Series titles, most of any singles player. Oh, look at that.
Service over. 9-4.
He's actually moving backwards, jumping backwards, and still controlling it. Such a nice soft touch.
Oh, there's another challenge here.
Song Wan Ho challenges. Court in.
Well, seeing as I got it completely wrong the last time, I'm not going to try and make judgment this time. Just going to leave it completely for Hawkeye. And the Hawkeye confirms that the line judge was correct.
Song Wan Ho, one challenge remaining. Play.
Oh, yeah.
Service over.
No, that's the second time in the last three or four rallies, isn't it, that he's played that cross-court smash as a winner?
Yeah.
It's very nicely done.
Yeah, that's normally his favorite shot. You know, the Danes have done a lot of video analysis on Song Wan Ho, because they couldn't really figure him out, but I think the last number of times the Danes played him, they've had the upper hand.
Line judge was unsighted.
Line judge unsighted.
So the umpire is asking for Hawkeye to tell us, and both players have walked off court. I think both players believe it was long. If it is long, we go to the mid-game interval. Well, the problem was Lee Chong Wei was between the line judge and the shuttle falling, so the line judge didn't get clear sight. And I think that's good line judging. If you can't see, say you can't see. Hawkeye's taking an age. Oh, it's landed in. Well, there you go. We're not going to the mid-game interval just yet.
6-10.
So a 5-point advantage here in the second game at the mid-game interval for Lee Chong Wei. Tae Soo Bok giving the instructions this time. Two of his victories here, one by beating Lin Dan in the final. It was 2005 and 2006. Twice beat Park Sung Wang. What on earth happened to him now? Hang on, wait a minute. What's going on here? Smash placement today. Now, the reds are out white right winners. Yellow's unreturned. That was the one down, the body smash, I remember.
Yeah. I noticed the percentages that it was like 55% to the backhand side of Sun Wen Ho. That's pretty much what I could derive from it on a short notice.
Seven over. 7-11. Oh, he's missed it.
Yeah.
He's missed it.
Good net shot from Sung Wan Ho, sets up the attack, and actually quite a good attack as well. But this one shows that he's not a native attacking player.
It's gone wide. But do you think he's right to try and follow up on his smashes?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
So even if he isn't a natural at following forward and playing the kill, he's got to try and do it.
Yes. The playing conditions simply demands it.
Yeah. Initially think that was going to go over, but it was perfect. Just that simple little block.
Yeah, I think he was really lucky, Lee Chong Wei, because he played it too close. I liked the shot from Sung Wan Ho, but sometimes you're lucky and sometimes it's your day, like the smash here.
It's poetry in motion, isn't it? The way Lee Chong Wei leaps in the air, plays that shot. The percentages down the backhand side will be going up even more, won't they now, from Lee Chong Wei?
Service over. 9:50.
Now you see what a contrast in the follow-up to the net after a smash between the two players.
Yeah, exactly. Lee Chong Wei is so fast at the net. Gets almost always, at least in this match, good opportunities. Whereas we've seen since someone who missed that a big opportunity at the net, he's not really gone for it as on the follow-up shots. He's just played on and on and on, and that makes him give Lee Chong Wei too many chances.
Yeah, there was hesitation. That really cost him dear. Thought about leaving it. Saw Wan Ho, then decided to play it on the backhand. Yeah, that was a softer smash, wasn't it?
Softer smash and doesn't get you too much out of balance. You can move faster forward. Wouldn't have been able to follow up on his attack, though. Very, very good return from Lee Chong Wei. And come over. And that's one of the quality differences between the good players and the very best players. The accuracy in the defense, so important that you don't leave any chances open for your opponent to follow up on their initial attack. And Lee Chong Wei, Chen Long, Lin Dan, they're really, really strong at that.
Points in the quarterfinal, Lee Chong Wei. And really, since that 4-point deficit at the mid game interval of the opening game, I think Lee Chong Wei, although it was close score in the opening game, I felt he's been very much in control.
Yeah.
That's a nice play.
Had he won this point here, he would have won double as many points as his opponent since exactly that mid-game interval.
11-19. Oh, it's gone wide. Well, Lee Chong Wei a little bit lucky about that, because he didn't anticipate that at all. He was left stranded. Match point opportunities for the 10-time former champion. Oh, little bit of trickery. Lovely. And again, it's a steep smash with very little pace on it from Son Wan Ho doing the damage. Look at that. That's terrific. All about placement and angle. Well, delaying the inevitable, one suspects, but I've seen stranger things happen. He's taken it. Yeah. So 21-18, 21-12, and Lee Chong Wei through to the quarterfinal. The number two seed, the megastar here in Malaysia. Yeah, he was going to leave it. Then decides he's going to play it, and his opponent gifted him with the unforced error. ...46 minutes in total for that victory. 21-18, 21-12. So he'll play against Victor Axelsen tomorrow in the quarterfinal. So our next match, we turn our attention to women's singles. And it's the number three seed, Saina Nehwal of India, up against the left-handed Bei Yongju. Bei Yongju, of course, was a beaten finalist here 6 years ago, 2010, lost out to the left-handed Wan Sin. So it was a battle of the left-handers in that final 6 years ago. In fact, she had to retire injured. I remember it well. She hurt her ankle. So, as far as this match is concerned, well, this is the bottom half of the draw, and all other quarterfinal places have been decided. And the big shock, of course, is the number eight seed, the All England champion, Okuhara.